Hey there, it's Daria here again, and today we got away from the office on purpose. The reason, dear friends, is to show you what you can do if you purchase yourself a quadcopter. After watching this episode, you'll most definitely know all the do's and don'ts when it comes to working with this creature. Many people dream of getting one of these technical wonders, as having a quadcopter means you can get amazing shots and see the world around you from a whole different perspective. However, I do have to warn you, soaring upward the minute you've unpacked your new toy will sadly not be possible. We need to get ready. Setting up your quadcopter, sensor calibration, and signing in with an account will take a little while. Today we're going to talk about settings and navigation using DJI Phantom 4 Advanced and DJI Spark models as examples. First, you need to calibrate the GPS, compass, and other sensors. If you're at home or anywhere indoors, the calibration may not work because of a poor satellite signal. That's why it's better be done outside.
Pay special attention to the maximum height and flight range settings, the speed, the height of automatic landing, and the sensitivity of the sensors.
After all the settings are done, make sure to charge the quadcopter and remote batteries fully before the first flight. Also, don't forget to charge your smartphone if there is no separate screen on the copter's remote control. Pick a day for the flight. It's dangerous to fly in the temperatures above 35 degrees Celsius or below freezing. Also, avoid strong winds or rain. It can cause to lose control and damage the electronics. It is also not a good idea to fly in the dark or at twilight. The best shots come at the so-called golden hour. In photography, that means the hour after daybreak and 2 hours before sunset. Pick a location for your flight. Make sure that flights are allowed in your selected area. It is strictly prohibited to fly drones close to airports and other restricted access facilities. Also, make sure that you avoid private territories and other out-of-bounds areas. Wires, houses, mountains, trees, ponds. Make sure there is nothing that might appear on the horizon that will interfere with your flight. It is better to pick an open location without people around for your first launch. A clear field, a large meadow, or a desert would be perfect. Choose the takeoff and landing spot. I wouldn't recommend you launch your quadcopter from your hands. Many modern quadcopters are perfectly capable of returning straight to the takeoff area and landing in case of emergency, let's say if the battery is running low. The takeoff spot should be flat and dry, and there should be no unnecessary objects that might interfere with the rotor. There should be no obstacles in the way.
Don't count on taking breathtaking shots right away. Keep in mind that a quadcopter battery runs down very quickly. Most run from 10 to 30 minutes. Your first few flights will be test runs. The operating time will be over by the time you have figured out how to navigate and get used to handling the machine. It pretty much feels like learning how to drive a car. At first, you learn some simple maneuvers at a test track. Your movements are stiff and you're frightened most of the time. It is just the same with a quadcopter. So don't be keeping your fingers crossed that you'll be able to film something decent on your first try. If you purchased a quadcopter to shoot an important event, you'll have to spend some time on a few trial flights ahead of time.
It is crucially important to keep track of the battery level on your quadcopter. If your drone is equipped with an auto-return home function, it will warn you about the low charge and land by itself. But even if it is set up to do so, do your best not to fly too far and try to keep your quadcopter close to potential landing areas at a reasonable altitude, especially if the charge is lower than 35%. As you get used to navigating your quadcopter, you'll learn to quickly and safely bring it home, even at a lower charge. But in the first 5 to 10 flights, proceed with caution, unless you want to accidentally lose your quadcopter. If you have spare batteries, don't drop the charge any lower than 30% in your trial flights. Don't push the battery to the limit.
Try the easiest maneuvers first. Height gain. Then a downward flight. Feel the speed your quadcopter is moving. Be aware of a shifting, even in a slight wind, which will mean that after gaining height, you'll have to modify its position to bring it back to the starting point. Now try back and forth movements. Most commonly, a different joystick controls this movement, but it depends on your controller's settings. The next step is turning the drone on its own axis. In my case, I do this by pushing the first joystick upwards. The final stage of the maneuver is to move the quadcopter to the left and to the right. Try the movement in each direction separately. When you feel the movements become smooth and you have a handle on which joysticks control what movements, carefully try to maneuver the drone through multiple planes simultaneously. This is exactly how quadcopter control is done. You combine the movements in different planes with different degrees of intensity. For instance, a turn on the move is done like this. You move the quadcopter forward and make an extremely smooth turn on its own axis. In this case, I let the right joystick go forward all the way, and I shift the left one a bit to the left or right. If I push it too hard, the quadcopter will lose speed and turn too sharply, or just rotate instead of turning.
Don't fly blind. Don't lose sight of your drone. Keep looking at it every few seconds. Even experienced pilots try to follow their quadcopters by eye instead of continuously staring at the remote screen. Despite all the high-tech system designed to automatically bypass obstacles, a quadcopter may still not see thin branches, wires, and other obstacles. Besides, it can be carried away by a sudden gust of wind, or the video signal on the remote can be lost. In this case, it will be hard to bring it back to the place where it was if you lost track of it a while ago.
As soon as you have a feel for the navigation, you can try video or photo shooting. Start with the basic tricks of shooting with a quadcopter. Pull the camera down, switch video recording on, and start ascending. The shots will get increasingly interesting as the ground gets farther and farther away. Too easy for you! Add a slight rotation to the quadcopter by moving the joystick a little to the left or right. Here is what you'll get. Now do the opposite, pull the camera upwards all the way. Ascend about 100 meters, then just move forward. You'll get an amazing extra long shot with a horizon trace. Do not attempt to shoot smooth, breathtaking shots using just camera movement. Most commonly, the camera movement on quadcopters can only be changed within the range of 90 degrees upward and downward. That is, you can direct your camera straight toward the skyline and parallel to the ground, or let it go all the way downwards. Bear in mind that you need to modify your shooting angle right before you start shooting, rather than during the shooting. To put it simply, you have to choose the camera direction angle first, let's just say 45 degrees, and then get to the shooting. Smooth shooting on the move is achieved by means of careful quadcopter navigation, not camera adjustments.
Following these easy tips, you'll soon learn how to navigate your drone more easily, and you'll be less likely to damage something or someone in some way. If you want to learn more about quadcopters and interesting tricks with aerial photography, leave us a comment. And it's about time for us to come up with interesting ideas for future episodes.
Oopsie daisy, I nearly forgot. I really want to share some good news with you. Movavi is launching a summer sale of their best programs. For instance, you can get a video editor or media files converter or software for screen recording at a discount of 40 or 30%. Or you may want to buy a set of Movavi programs, a video suite, at 60% off. Can you believe it? The sale will last for 1 week only, from the 24th to the 31st of July. To access the secret site with the discounts, go to the Movavi website and sign up for a subscription. A special form will pop up where you can enter your email. On the first day of the sale, that is on the 24th of July, you will get an invitation with a secret link. Just follow the link and you'll get the discounts. Like the video if you found it interesting, subscribe to our channel, and take good care of yourselves.